and Chainz has been on the road for about a year straight. They've opened up for Megadeth, Iggy Pop, Anthrax, Slayer. But tonight's the opening of their biggest tour yet, one of their influences, Van Halen.
I was really a huge fan of the band when I was younger. So it's kind of neat. It's all kind of coming around.
Alice in Chains is one of my favorite new bands. I think they're great.
Chains hails from Seattle, Washington, a city that's been in the rock and roll spotlight as of late, so much so that director Cameron Crowe is making a film about it. Matt Dillon stars, Alice in Chains makes an appearance, and the film is called Singles.
It's loosely based on the Seattle music scene, and it's got a lot of great bands. Pearl Jam is in it, Soundgarden, ourselves, basically performing as ourselves.
But Seattle as a music mecca is not a new phenomenon.
You got Bing Crosby, Jimi Hendrix, Robert Cray, Hart, Queensryche. I mean, it's like throughout the years there's been a steady outflow.
It's just people just now, the record companies just now jumped on and turned it into what it's always been.
But who is Alice, and why is she in Chains?
The name originates from five drunk guys forming a thrash band in which they would all dress in drag. And that band never got formed, and I was one of those people, and I kept the name.
At first listen, Alice in Chains' music may seem very brooding, but the band says that's not what they're about at all.
We're not putting a negative message out to people. We're saying get your negative crap out and have a good time. Don't let it stay inside of you and ruin you.
Yeah, we don't sit around and bummed out all day and burn black candles and wine or anything.
Why don't we all climb in my bunk? I'll show you guys. I'm a little lonely, Mike, so why don't you scoot over?
Your girlfriends worry about the fact that two people can fit in these bunks?
Two men, yes.
Yeah, they worry about that.
Alice in Chains on tour now with Van Halen. Time for a... Oh,